Okay, this tutorial is to show you a little bit of special effects. You're not going to need a lot of special effects for this project, but if you want to change the saturation level on your photos, meaning making them brighter or darker, or turning things black and white, or resizing images, I'm going to show you how to do that. So let's say I want to use this photo right here. I brought in a baby picture of myself as an archival photo. One of my first lines of my poem says, "I am from bear country." So instead of using this stock photo of a bear, it's much better to use an actual photo from your personal archives to make this more personal. So I'm going to drag down my first photo. And I see that it's kind of small. I want to make this photo bigger. So I'm just going to double click. Whenever you want to do special effects, you just double click on whatever photo you're looking at. So again, if I had my photos, if they were upside down, I could rotate them here. I could flip the perspective. I can change the scale right here. So if I want to zoom into myself as a baby, I'm going to move this up like that. That's me and my sister on Halloween one year. And then if you come up here to these other tabs, here's where you can change different effects. So if you change, if you click on this, this is cropping. You can crop parts of your photo out horizontally, meaning the side of it. Right? If I want to crop out parts, if I wanted to crop out my sister and just have me, I could do that. Or vertically is the top and bottom. I don't want to do that on this project, so I will leave those alone. This next tab right here is to animate it, and you're not going to need to do that. If you want to get fancy, you can ask me, but this can, you can tell the computer where you want it to start and where you want it to end. So maybe I wanted my picture to start real small right here, and then if I click on the tab that says end, then I want it to end to be real zoomed in, then I can do that, and it will...
I am from bear country, from let down your hair country.
That allows your photos to kind of zoom in. They call it the Ken Burns effect because he's a documentary filmmaker that was known for making images kind of have a little bit of movement to them. I'm not going to do that one. However, if you did like what you, the changes that you made, you always hit save changes. Okay. So I'm not going to, I'm just going to reset that to zero. I don't really want any changes there. Okay. So let's reset it. Let's put it back actually in the middle. I'm going to go back to my first tab. And I'm going to remove that animation. Okay, the next tab is right here. This is color keying. I'm not going to show you that. That's for green screen effects. But the last tab right here, this little circle, this is about your color, contrast, saturation. So if I wanted to make this real bright, kind of lighten up my photo, I could move that slider up. Or if I wanted to make my photos black and white because they're old photos, I can slide that down to make it a black and white photo. And then... same thing with the tint and the temperature. This is kind of like adding filters to your project. So then I click save changes. And now when that photo plays in my timeline, it is black and white.
I am from bear country, from let down your hair country. Strawberry patch picking, blueberry eating, belly dancer under a blue sky.
Okay, so if I like it, I keep it. I'm going to double click though. If I don't like it, I'm going to just go back and I can just hit this reset button if I want it to go back to its normal and save changes. So that's all for special effects for this portion of your video. Next unit, you guys are going to be editing movie trailers, and there's a lot more special effects you can do with those.